हेलो गाइस एंड वेलकम टू आवर यूट्यूब चैनल स्क्रैच लर्नर्स। टुडे वी विल सी द 8085 प्रोग्राम टू फाइंड आउट द सम ऑफ एन बी सी डी नंबर्स। ओके, सो आई होप यू ऑल नो हाउ टू फाइंड आउट द सम और एडिशन ऑफ टू और मोर नंबर्स इन जनरल, राइट? वी हैव सीन दैट वीडियो ऑफ 8085 माइक्रो प्रोसेसर, बट द डिफरेंस हियर इज दैट वी नीड टू फाइंड आउट द सम ऑफ बी सी डी नंबर्स। So what is a BCD number? It is binary coded decimal number. We know that all the operation in microprocessor are being performed in hexadecimal form, right? So all the result that we get for summation will be in hexadecimal. But if we sum the numbers in BCD, that means if we want to get the sum that is in BCD format, then we have to do some operation, and this is nothing but the numbers that we are getting in decimal. Okay, so in this program we will not be getting the output in hexadecimal, but we will get the output of the sum in decimal format. Let's try to add two numbers, 74 and 86. Okay, these are the two numbers. So if we add them in hexadecimal, okay, so these numbers are in hexadecimal, so if we add them in hexadecimal, what we'll get? 6 plus 4 is equals to 10 in decimal, but in hexadecimal 10 is equals to A, right? And here 7 plus 8 is equals to 15, that means we will get F. So if we just perform the addition of two numbers in 8085, then we will be getting this as the output, but here we want the result in BCD format. So what is the rule of conversion of any number in BCD format is, if the digit is greater than 9, then we have to add 6 with it. Okay, so if the digit of a number is greater than 9, then we will add 6 with that digit. And if the digit is lesser than 9, then we have two cases. First, when the carry is 0, and the second when the carry is 1. So what does it mean? Let's say another number like 94 and 86. Let's try to add them. Then 6 plus 4 is equals to A, and 9 plus 18 in normal decimal format, this is equals to what? 17, right? But if we write 17 in hexadecimal format, then 17 is equals to 12. So we will write 12 here. Now the carry is shifted from this position to this position, right? See, in these bits 8 plus 9 we are performing, so here a carry is generated, but the digit here is lesser than 9, so this satisfies this condition. So in that case, what we'll do, we will again add 6 with that digit. That means here in addition of 94 and 86 hex in BCD format, if we want to convert this hexadecimal number into BCD, then we have to add 6 here and 6 here. So when A is added with 6, we will get 10. How? Because we know that after A, B, C, D, E and F, 10 comes, then 11, 12 and so on. So A plus 6, that means A plus 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So here we get 10. That means we'll write 0 here. 1 will be going as the carry. Then 1 plus 2 is equals to 3, and 3 plus 6. So what is the value of 3 plus 6? It's 9. So we'll write 9 here and this 1. Okay, so this is the result of the BCD addition of 94 and 86 hex. So this is the sum in hexadecimal, and this is the equivalent BCD number. So in this way, we can perform the summation of two numbers in BCD format. But in 8085 microprocessor, by performing a single instruction, we can convert the hexadecimal numbers into BCD format. Okay, so now we will be writing the 8085 program to find out the sum of n BCD numbers. So if you understand the method of finding the summation of n BCD numbers, then you can easily find out the summation of 2 or 3 BCD numbers, right? So I am writing the 8085 program for addition of 5 BCD numbers. So first of all, I'll input the total number of elements in the array. So let's initialize C register with 0,5 hex, that is 5 element will be added. Then first of all, we will input the first data from C050 hex memory location. That means the first input will be inputted from C050 hex, and we are initializing the HL register pair to point to C050 hex address. Let's move it into the accumulator, and as we have inputted the first data, let's decrement the count of the number of elements, that is DCRC. Now we will input another element and go on adding that number with the content of accumulator. So INXH, this will input the second data, right? Then we will add accumulator with memory. That means this will perform what? Accumulator will be A plus M. So here we have the result of addition of first two numbers. Now after addition, there may be a condition when a carry may generate or may not generate. So we have to take in account that part also. So JNC loop, that means jump if no carry is generated. Now this will jump to some location if a carry is not generated. But if a carry is generated, then we have to store that carry part also. So for that, let's initialize in the beginning another register, let's say B with 00 hex. Okay, so here we will increment the content of B register. That means now B will be containing 1 if a carry is generated. Okay, now we will decrement the content of C. So this loop will be going to this location. That means if a carry is not generated, then we will directly decrease the content of C. We need to check whether the content of C is equals to 0 or not. So to check the content of C is equals to 0 or not, we will perform JNZ loop. If it is not equals to 0, then it will jump to which location? To here. Okay, let's say this is loop 2 and this is loop 1. Okay, so if the content of C is not equals to 0, then the control will go to this location so that we can fetch the next data, and we will add that data with the content of accumulator. Alright, so this loop will be repeated until we add all the elements in the array, right? So after addition of all the elements, we have our result into the accumulator, and the carry part is stored in register B, right? So now we have our hexadecimal result, but we want to convert it into BCD number. I have already said that by performing a single instruction, we can convert the hexadecimal result into our BCD result. So that instruction is DAA. That means decimal adjust accumulator. So what it will do is, it will convert the hexadecimal result of the accumulator into BCD format. So by just performing this instruction, we have got our BCD result. Now the last task is to store our results, right? So as we know that the main part of the result is in the accumulator, so first of all, store that data into C060 hex address, let's say. Okay, and now we have also to store this carry part, right? So for that, first of all, we will move that content of B into the accumulator, and then we will store that result into C061 hex address, let's say, and then halt. Okay, so this is how we can find the summation of n BCD numbers. Here we have added up 5 numbers as we have initialized the C register with 0,5 hex, right? If you want to perform the addition of 10 numbers, then you could initialize the C register with 0A hex. Okay, if you properly examine this program, then you will be able to know that this program is nothing but the addition of a series of numbers. Right, we have already seen that program. So by just adding DAA instruction in that program, you can find out the sum of n BCD numbers. If you want to add the summation of 2 BCD numbers, either you can follow this program, or one more thing you can do is, you already have the program of addition of 2 numbers in 8085, right? So just after addition add DAA instruction, and by doing just that thing you can get the BCD result. Okay, so I hope this video is clear to you. In the next video we will see how to perform the subtraction of two BCD numbers. So see you in the next video. Thank you.